Radha Menon.
And I'm Titus Dawo. Welcome to Xpress.
A brand new first-class entertainment show from the Midlands.
Xpress is a show that aims to tease you with a mix of stories that we know will please you.
So go get your ticket and come on board.
On board today's Xpress, we look at a dynamic duo who combine rap with jazz.
Bombay fashions, what's hot and what's not.
The Xpress meal you can cook in just 15 minutes.
In Video Slam, we check out the best summer videos, and the exhibition Bird takes us into the darker side of jazz.
And we'll be tearing up the dance floor with our Ragga guide.
But first, superstars Sharron Davis and Derek Redmond. What's married life like away from the crowds?
This is it. I think we found it.
It's a bit posh, isn't it? You're sure it's Sharron Davis and Derek Redmond?
The swimming pool.
Basketball.
Derek!
Yes, can I help you?
Hi. I'm Radha from Xpress.
I'm Titus from Xpress. How are you doing?
What's Xpress?
Brand new magazine programme from Central.
Oh, okay. Sharron!
Can I have a few words with you?
Yeah.
I've been wanting to talk to you for ages.
Seems you've got a good haircut like mine, no problem. Sit down and ask away.
Oh, great. So how have you been keeping anyway? What have you been up to? We haven't seen you for ages.
Oh, I've been having injury problems, as people know, over the last 3 years. Still having injury problems now, so I've decided to hang up the old spikes and call it a day and basically get on with the rest of my life.
Well, this is great. I mean, is this what you get from off the track? Bosh, how's everything?
Well, I wouldn't say it was all down to athletics. It's both Sharon's and I's anyway, so we both have pretty good careers. And like everything else, when people sort of, you know, do well in their careers and earn a little bit of money, it's nice to kind of reward yourselves with, you know, with a nice house and nice cars and that sort of thing.
I'm a very ambitious person, as is Derek, and it's not so much that I want more out of life. I need things to go for. I like a challenge. It's what makes me get up in the morning and want to go and perform again. I want to go and do a job better than I did it last time. That's the way I work.
What is Derek Redmond really up to now?
Sharon and I have got a company called Fitness 400 that does a personal fitness program, so if you want to get yourself in shape, give us a call. I'm just trying to get my fingers in many pies as I can at the moment and see what happens. Yeah.
I'm very, very happy. I'm more content than I've ever been in my life. We each have our own space. Derek has things that he wants to do and he goes off and does that. And I do things that I want to do and yet we always come back and discuss them. And you know, it means that we're equal partners. We're equal partners financially, emotionally. So if you think all we do is run and swim, you'd be wrong. This is the centre of our universe, really. This is where we do all our work from, book all our appointments and order our equipment for the gym. It's nice because it's close to home, obviously. Elliot could be wandering around outside and we're never late for work, are we?
Not really. And talking of late for work, you got to go to Liverpool at 4 o'clock to open that leisure centre.
Well, I suppose I better go and get ready. Now.
Come on, Derek. Man to man now. What really attracted you to Sharon?
What attracted me to Sharon in the first place? Obviously, the first thing I'd lie to say it wasn't looks. I thought she had wicked legs. So seeing her in a swimsuit did it for me.
Sharon, tell us what really attracted you to Derek. Was it his sexy legs?
I think what attracted me to Derek in the first place was his smile and his sexy bald head. I actually like his crooked teeth. I think he's got a very cheeky smile and very shiny eyes. So it's lots of things. I mean, I think obviously it would be probably fibbing if I said it wasn't physical, you know, initially, like most people. But then once you get to know somebody, it's what they're like themselves and what sort of interests they have and what type of person he is. And he's very easygoing. We have an awful lot in common.
Did you have to wait a long time before you decided you were serious and took him home to mum?
It must have been a few months, but we were both in a situation where we were sort of tidying ends up and finishing relationships. I was still married and I had to sort my divorce out and everything, so we just thought it was more sensible to take things slowly than to rush, really. But I think I probably met his mum and dad after 2 or 3 months and vice versa. And they get on, we get on very well, you know, there's no hang-ups, really. I mean, for both of us, we've been brought up in sport, where people are all shapes and sizes and colours, and it's irrelevant, really. At the end of the day, it's just the person.
Elliot, what do you want?
What do you want, Elliot?
Do you want a bit of this, or do you want a bit of that?
Quite a lot of relationships go through a lot of stress when a child is born. Did you have a problem when Elliot was born?
He was tough in the fact that he wanted to be fed every 2 hours for the first 3 months, which meant it was pretty hard work because I was feeding him for the first 3 months. But Derek did his fair share. You know, he got up with me. That was the big difference. It wasn't just the baby's crying, go feed him. It was the baby's crying, let's go feed him. And even if I was feeding, he would come and sit and talk to me. So he was as tired as I was, which helped quite a lot. It sounds silly, but it really did. It helped an awful lot.
He's changed our lives, obviously. The first people say to me, what's the first thing that changes? You know, lack of sleep is the first thing that goes. But no, he's great. He's really brought a lot of joy into both of our lives. He's a wonderful boy. Can't wait till he's older so I can take him out playing football and basketball and really messing around with him. But no, he's really good.
Oh, well, Derek, I am very impressed. How long have you had the gym here?
Thanks. We've had it it's been finished about 3 or 4 months now, but we've been working on it for about the last 6 to 8 months. We've had quite a lot of equipment before, and we're really happy with it. It's happy with the result that we've got.
Well, listen, I've got to go now, so it's been a pleasure talking to you.
You too.
Maximum respect.
But you're not finished now, are you?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. We've got another shoot.
No. You've got to pay for this interview. I mean, you've walked in. You've got a bit of exercise, pain, sweat. Come on, on you get.
Come on.
I've been looking at you TV guys, and you know, you spend a lot of these times at home. Come on, what's this? Come on, all this bloody rich food that you guys eat.
I know that Derek's put Titus through his paces. It's your turn now. Let's have a look how you swim. It's nice and warm anyway. Good stuff. Stretch out as far as you can. Brilliant.
Come on, stop mumbling, boy. Stop mumbling.
That's not bad at all.
Come on. You can stop after you've done 500.
Good stuff. Brilliant.
What about the arms? Come on. Look at this flab. Look at this. Come on, what are you, man or a mouse?
Squeak.
Bye.
See ya.
Bye. Who were those people?
I don't know, TV presenters, got no stamina.
No stamina whatsoever.
And now, two bad brothers from the world of jazz, saxophonist Alvin Davis and rapper Moose. Their combination of jazz and hip-hop is kicking up a storm. So blow, guys, blow.
Try to sort it out in my mind. Cause you're the only answer that I find. You're so good and right in my sight. Well, if I'm wrong, I don't wanna be right. So all's I pray you never do me wrong. My loving you just goes on and on. Gently touching as I close my eyes. And then I'll step into your paradise.
A lot of things have traditionally started in England with jazz compared to like soul or reggae or hip-hop. It's a bit more melodic, but the basis of it is rhythm, and rap is about rhythm. It's about rhythm, words, combination, movements, all these things.
Working with Moose was fairly easy actually, because he's got a very open mind in terms of a lot of music. His outlook on a lot of music is very wide, so no difficulty in working with Moose.
People are listening to more and more music, you're taking in more influences, so you know there's so many different directions, and if you take in like reggae and rap or soul, jazz, R&B, you're taking all these things, you'll come to some kind of that sounds different. It's not necessarily new, but it sounds different.
Could it be the way you're holding me? Touch my body, I'm in ecstasy.
Rap and jazz are both very expressive types of music. To combine was quite easy. It's just a matter of the formula, what type of song to create around the jazz style and the rap style.
England is really a melting pot of music. You get to listen to so many different influences. I think England is more the experimental lab for these kind of things.
These days of our lives.
We can't wait to rush home to watch Xpress on Central Television.
Xpress. Guess why I'm dressed like this? I sometimes get fed up of wearing jeans and trainers. It's nice to wear something beautiful and traditional. But where do you get exclusive designer Asian wear? At Chiravi's in Birmingham, you can find the latest designs straight from Bombay, especially for girls like me.
When I started the shop, this was supposed to be where East meets the West. We have suppliers and designers in Bombay. Whenever a new fashion, new trend is out in Bombay, we are told straight away. The material used for most of the clothes are either cottons and silks, chiffons, art silk, and polyester. When somebody walks in here, we make sure that the outfit they choose suits them. We do the alterations for them, if it's a bit loose or tight or anything. And we also supply them with proper accessories to go with it, shoes, handbags, proper makeup as well. So when they walk out of the shop, they are properly dressed. Any lady that goes to a party can wear something which would blend in both the East and West designs, and they're not sort of out of place. When you look at an outfit, you might think that does cost in hundreds, but because they are very beautifully made, they look expensive, but they're not expensive, believe me.
And now for an exhibition with a difference entitled Bird. This unique collaboration combines photography, performance and jazz, which gives us a unique insight into the weird and wacky world of photographer Mark Taylor and performer Ronnie Fraser Munro.
A lot of people have found this very funny and very refreshing. There are a few people who've looked a little quizzical, and that's not a bad thing. I feel very comfortable with that.
This exhibition is called Bird. It brought together 16 characters played by myself. The photographs are reinventions of jazz. Mark Taylor is the photographer.
I know people might think that we're crazy off our heads, but that's not so, really. This kind of thing seems quite natural to us to want to produce it.
It's not difficult at all. I'm schizophrenic. It's something that that we both feel is important.
I would like to say that, for me, nothing is as sincere as irreverence. And jazz has been defined and appropriated and taken over by a lot of people who are very reverent. And I think there's something wonderful and delightful about this show in terms of its irreverence.
If anybody would be offended by the fact that we've used somebody like Charlie Parker's name in vain, then they'll have to live with that. Because, you know, we don't see it as anything particularly disrespectful. And even if we did, then all the better. Al Jolson is Asa Jolson, a white man portraying a black man at the beginning of the century.
The actual reason I've been following these characters around all day is because Ronnie is a bit of a chameleon type of character, and I have to wait in the wings and wait for him to transform and then catch him just at that moment. And, you know, sometimes that could take days, weeks.
Heinrich Goebbels is possibly, to most people, the most unacceptable face of jazz. He believes that jazz music is just a vehicle in order to get into people's minds. Heinrich's songwriting is probably the tops, so far as German jazz composition is concerned. And it's Heinrich's intention that by the end of the 20th century, every foot in Western Europe will be tapping to the music of Altmann Riffer.
God,
Schwein Hund.
I would hope that people, after looking at this, would, you know, feel enlightened by it. And although there's a serious element, a serious thread running through it, you know, it's just the humour that sort of we hope will draw people in.
My attitude is that people will make of it what they will, and I don't think that you can control people's mind to that degree. So if people like it or find it offensive or whatever, then I'm quite happy. So long as it gets a reaction, then that's fine.
I see myself as being quite straight, really. And it's Ronald, really. He's a twisted one, sick and malevolent, you know, beyond belief. On the whole, no, I'd say I was fairly ordinary sort of player.
I go by the name of Coolio with the flow down to go toe-to-toe with any Hank Frank or Joe straight from the Mad Circle. I'm doing it for 94. When I'm in the Midlands, I check out Xpress, you know what I'm saying? The rockin' is rockin' this show on Central Television. Yeah, and it's like that.
Noticed, like, because I like to go to the movies and everything. Sean Connery, what's this guy really on? I mean, like, when he was 007, right, the British secret agent in the 60s, he had the shark chant. I mean, the other night I was watching Sean Connery in The Untouchables, in which Sean Connery plays a Chicago cop, and yet he had the same accent. I mean, over Christmas, I don't know if you saw The Hunt for Red October, in which Sean Connery plays a Russian, you know, submarine commander, and yet he had the same accent. What's next? Are they going to ask Sean Connery to play the Dr. Martin Luther King? So like, free at last, thank God Almighty, we're free at last. For God's sake, I hope not.
Radha, what are you doing? You're not supposed to be eating this stuff. Don't you want to know about some good food?
I'm hungry, Titus.
Well, listen, this is the time of the program where Xpress gives you its quick food guide, where in 15 minutes, a chef will teach you how to cook a tasty traditional meal.
I have one very special dish for me and my wife, and I'm going to show you what it is. The name of it is a porkafilia, and it's a lean pieces of pork. It will take about 15 minutes, but you can even do it less than the time. And what you do, you just cut it into small pieces. Right, the meat is ready. So what we're going to do now, we're going to add some ingredients into the meat. Cinnamon sticks, some bay leaves, a pinch of pepper, a pinch of salt, and the most important of it, coriander seed. It's very easy to obtain from everywhere, cash and carries, or in the supermarkets. When you do that, you add some pure olive oil. Before you stir it, you put some medium dry red wine from my vineyards. You stir it a little bit, so it marinates. But before you put it into your fry pan, you add some vegetable oil. The flavors, my God, very quickly rise. So I would choose some onions first. Here we go. A bit of cinnamon, a bit of the bay leaves. And this time I'm going to put some pure vegetable oil. Add all the onions into it and the bay leaves. And I will put the rice into the boil. And I'm going to add the water. In the meantime, I'm going to show you how to do a very special and easy dish for a starter, which just the ingredients is yogurt, bit of garlic, dry mint, pinch of salt. And I'll show you what I have done earlier, the garlic and the cucumber. And I add it into my bowl. Like yogurt, dry mint, salt in it. As I'm cooking sometimes, I base the bottle on my head and cooking with it. And to really give it a very good flavor, you put some pure olive oil. And I'll tell you something, when you eat it with some bitter bread, it tastes fantastic. It's also a vegetarian dish if you want to. And now we're going to check our rice and the meat, because I think they're ready. The rice, it has took only 5 minutes to be cooked. I will check my meat, which I believe now. Oh my God, look at that. It's beautiful, golden meat. Lovely. I'll tell you something, it looks beautiful, like a beautiful woman. Oh, as you can see, in 15 minutes, we create a beautiful dish called poca feglia with some beautiful rice, tzatziki. Anybody can do it.
But I can do it better, darling.
Cheers.
Now, if you've been to a reggae dance recently, you might think that dancing can seriously damage your health. We've had the Armstrong, the butterfly, the gingy fly, and many other types of dances. But how do you do them? You at home, clear your front room, as Xpress shows you with its quick step guide to dance all moves.
Me all a walk like a champion, talk like a champion. What a piece of money, girl, tell me where you get it from. Knock on your entrance, ram pa pa pam pam. Can't let me in, me have the thing where you are waiting for. Walk like a champion, talk like a champion. What a piece of money, girl, how will you get it from. Knock on your entrance, ram pa pa pam pam. Can't let me in, why? Cause you would be more than dead to take your hand and lead you to the promised land. Me turn the food time, man. All you got to do is be true, so let's correspond. Satisfy your emotion. At a body press, instantly she was. She no hole and tongue, and she no got none of us. Things smooth and precious, like she never get a cut. Once on the expand, I've got to all and pull up.
If you know your body ready, and you're not a yard, wave up your one in the air like a flag. And if you know your man love your body bad. Jump, girl, pick me and galang. It's like 90 girl already. Get the big one mark. Muggle with your man and make them get them back out.
Fire word. Flash up with the light and you style about ya coming from the militant soldier. In other words, known as black and blood. Set the clip on a position, woman and man. Coming at ya. Flick, flash up on the lighter. Hot lighter, what that's the new style, the voucher. It's a danger, flash up on the lighter. Every youth man a walk with clipper, how we call it clipper. Yes, that's the new lighter, Bunsen burner. I run things in every era, how we call it clipper. Yes, that's the new style, cut. Youth man, flash up your lighter and move down the gun.
Money make the girls like glitter every time. So from you get the money, y'all jump up and whine. All them other them can't hold you no time. Your body expensive, you a fashion design. Sing, so from a you a get the kind. Jump up and a stop galang whine. Walk on the road and kill them with a pretty smile. Girl can't dance, can't give him a crocodile. Sing.
Looks like we've come to the end of today's Xpress. I really hope that you've enjoyed it. On next week's...
Shh, don't tell them. If you want to know what's on next week, hop on the Xpress. It's the wickedest, baddest show.
From the Midlands. Later.
I hate that Titus, you know.
But that Radha's all right, you know. Right? Yeah.